ASMR Movie Geek, and today I have a special movie review for Wonder Woman. I recently went to the movie theater to watch the new DC movie, Wonder Woman, and just before I get started with this review, I wanted to mention that any spoilers I will mark as spoilers, and you don't have to worry if you haven't watched the movie yet. I will give a spoiler warning before, and I'm probably going to talk about spoilers near the end of this video, so if you just watch the beginning, you should be fine, and I will give a warning, so don't worry if you haven't seen the film yet. So, basically, Wonder Woman is the fourth DC movie, part of the DC cinematic universe that they're trying to create. Man of Steel, Batman v Superman, and Suicide Squad are the other DC movies in this universe. Justice League is coming out later, and basically I've seen all the other movies at the theater, and I went to go see Wonder Woman as well, and I have to say that it's one of my favorites out of the DC films, out of the newer DC films. First off, the director they got for the movie is Patty Jenkins, and she's a great director. She directed this movie called Monster that came out in the early 2000s. It starred Charlize Theron and Christina Ricci, both great actresses, and a very serious movie, but it was directed very well, and people involved, you know, the actors did a great job. And Patty Jenkins basically directed Wonder Woman. She did a fantastic job with it. And the woman they got to play Wonder Woman in this film, or as her real name is Diana, of course, but most people know her as Wonder Woman. Similar to Clark Kent being the less popular name for Superman, since most people just know him as Superman. But the actress they got, I believe her name is Gal Gadot, but I have seen people pronounce her name as Gal Gadot, so I'm not sure. I think Gal Gadot sounds like the actual name, so that's what I'm probably going to call her. She really brought a lot of depth to the character. Wonder Woman in the comics is always like this really unique superhero, and I think she did justice to the character by portraying her in this movie correctly. So, the movie basically starts, or the general premise of the movie is an origin story, and Diana, who is Wonder Woman, is basically raised on this island, just like the comics, and this island is full of the Amazons, not people from the Amazon rainforest, that's completely different. The Amazons are the basically warrior race of all women warriors, and she's raised there along with her mother and a bunch of other people, and ever since she was young, she always wanted to be a strong fighter, and basically the initial part of the movie serves as an origin story. You see her grow up, and then we're introduced to Chris Pine's character. Chris Pine's character in the movie is called Steve Trevor, who is a, well, important part of the Wonder Woman story in the comics as well. They do take some liberties with his character in this movie, but overall, I'd say that Chris Pine played Steve Trevor in the best way possible, and yeah, I really enjoyed what his character brought to the movie. Basically, he arrives at the island where Wonder Woman is. He meets Diana. They leave the island together, and they're basically going out to search for the main villain of the film. This whole movie takes place during World War I, so the First World War, and they use like special filter effects when they were filming this movie, because on the island it's full of vibrant colors, but the second they leave the island to go to back to where Steve Trevor wants to take Diana, you get to see England at the time of World War I, and it's full of, you know, smog and pollution and all sorts of stuff. And Wonder Woman even comments on this fact, and she's like, wow, what a terrible place. So that caused the theater to laugh. They had a bunch of jokes in this movie that were funny, but it also had a lot of serious moments. So unlike Batman v Superman, which was mostly a serious movie, I feel like this movie had more of a balance between humor and seriousness that I liked. And yeah, the main villain of the movie is Ares, or if any of you know Greek mythology, Roman mythology, Ares is the god of war. Yes, god of war, just like the video game series. But Kratos is not the villain, it's Ares. And yeah, basically, Wonder Woman and her family, you know, are a race that has existed on this island for a very long time, since the ancient Greek gods on Mount Olympus were around. And they were basically created to defeat Ares if he ever came back. So that's basically the premise of this movie. They need to find out where Ares is, who Ares is, and defeat him. And amidst all of this stuff, you have a lot of, like, scenes between Steve Trevor, you know, going around to assemble a gang of misfits, you know, like they do in a lot of movies, similar to, like, Ocean's 11, where people basically assemble a team. You know, you got, like, the guy that's good at, I don't know, crafting, or the guy that's good at hunting, the guy that's good at sniping from a distance. You know, he basically assembles a team of people that he thinks will help them on their mission, and Steve Trevor has his own agenda, and Wonder Woman has her own. Steve Trevor is basically a spy of sorts, so he's trying to end the First World War by tracking down this lady called Dr. Poison. She's a very unique character in this movie. I really liked her performance. The actress that played her did a great job. Really cool character. And Wonder Woman is searching for Ares. So that's basically the general gist of it. I haven't spoiled anything yet, but that's basically the premise of the movie. Now for what I thought about general aspects of the film. I like the music a lot. Fantastic music pieces in this movie. And I really liked that they used the Wonder Woman theme from Batman v Superman. That was really nice. They used that track as their, like, theme song in this movie. So, I mean, I noticed that a lot of people at the movie liked that track as well, because when it came on, a bunch of people cheered and clapped, so that definitely was a fan favorite. The way the movie was filmed, Patty Jenkins, great director, she reminds me slightly of Catherine Bigelow in terms of angles that she uses for her movies. I'm not sure if anyone else noticed this, but just certain shots that she would use in this movie reminded me a lot of stuff like Catherine Bigelow did in the movies that she made. And they're both female directors, so there might be something to that. Really nice angles. Special effects were great in this movie. I could barely tell. They used green screen and CG. Most of the time, it looked very real. There were a few instances where you could obviously tell it was a green screen, mostly near the end of the movie, like they do with the final battles. But overall, the special effects were great. There was a lot of stunts and like action, so I was satisfied on that standpoint. Let's see, jokes. I already talked about jokes, music, visuals. What else? Yeah, that's basically it. The story was really nice. I really liked everything about this movie. The only thing I could nitpick about is I wish they maybe developed a little bit more on the other characters in this movie. Certain characters have a lot less screen time than Wonder Woman and Steve Trevor, who are basically the main cast of the movie. There are really interesting secondary characters that only get a few scenes, and they're really interesting, so I would have liked to know a lot more about them. But yeah, if you don't know anything about Wonder Woman, if you've never seen a DC movie, this is the perfect movie to go see. It's really easy to get into. You don't need any prior knowledge to the Wonder Woman universe. It's an origin story, so it basically tells you everything you need to know. With some deviations from the comic books, of course, but even that is handled very well. It has jokes, but it's also serious, so it knows when to be lighthearted and fun. Nice action scenes, really cool action scenes, and to top it all off, it's basically the first good female superhero movie. Because prior to Wonder Woman, the only, like, other female superhero movies that have come out are, like, Catwoman and Elektra. And those movies are not good. Elektra is based, basically, on the Daredevil movie with Ben Affleck. It was a pretty bad movie. And Catwoman with Halle Berry is often considered one of the worst superhero movies ever made. And let's see, there have been female superheroes that have appeared in other movies, you know, but I have to say that Wonder Woman is the first awesome one, like, of a very high quality. So if you want a cool movie, go check this one out. Highly recommend it. Best of the new DC films, I think. I think DC did a great job, and I hope they continue using Patty Jenkins in the future to direct more of their movies. Even though I like Zack Snyder, I agree that the way he directed Batman v Superman had some problems with it, so I feel like going forward, they need to get more directors that can offer something different. So now I'm going to talk about spoilers. So spoiler warning. seconds before I start talking about spoilers. 3, 2, 1. Okay. So, in this movie, like I said earlier, the main villains are basically Ares and Dr. Poison. Dr. Poison is this lady that's researching deadly gases to use in the First World War in order to destroy as many lives as possible. And it's really dangerous stuff, really intense scenes with her in the movie. She's also a really creepy character. She wears like this ceramic mask on her face. Honestly, near the end of the movie, she kind of has a, I wouldn't say they brush her aside, but it feels like they brush her aside and focus on Ares. She was a threat up until the end of the movie, and then they don't even bother fighting her or anything. So I was a little bit disappointed with that. But Ares turns out to be one of the good guys earlier in the movie that is Steve Trevor's boss. So Steve Trevor is a spy, and his boss, this guy that works with him, ends up being a traitor and ends up being Ares in disguise. And Ares tries to convince Wonder Woman that he needs her to fight with him, and that's her purpose in life and stuff like that. She obviously won't have it, and it culminates in this amazing battle. Really cool battle. Ares like transforms into his like original form with like armor and everything, and he fights Wonder Woman one on one. They're causing like mayhem all over, throwing stuff, metal shields. He has like this special attack where he can grab pieces of metal and shape them into swords and just throw them at her. So really cool stuff. Wonder Woman has the lasso of truth and other weapons in this movie. Really cool. And in a plot twist, the sword that Wonder Woman was using for most of the movie is called the God Killer. But at the end of the movie, when it gets destroyed, it's revealed that she is the God Killer, and that sword is basically not what she thought it was. So that was a nice twist. I like that. Let me think. Oh, this movie had like three really cool action scenes. Let me turn this up a second. So, the movie had like three really awesome action scenes. The best action scene is the one that's referred to as No Man's Land here on the internet. And it's a scene where Wonder Woman basically is out in the middle of the battlefield in the trenches in World War One, and No Man's Land is a place where no one can go because troops on the other side will shoot you down immediately if you try to cross, and it's this huge like wasteland area. And Wonder Woman overhears like this lady talking about how they took everything and she can't get back to her house, and like all the troubles that the war has caused, and she basically decides to get up and walk out of the trenches across No Man's Land and take back the land and give it to the people. So it's a really inspiring scene, and as she gets out of the trenches, you know, there's all these soldiers hiding, too afraid to get out. And the soldiers from the other side are like all these snipers, and they're basically shooting at her. And you get to see the bullets hitting Wonder Woman in slow motion as she deflects them with like her wrist braces. And it looks awesome. Like, it's one of the coolest scenes in the movie. I was like speechless when I saw it at the theater. I think it's one of the best DC action scenes in a while. And after she crosses the field, all the soldiers from her side run across the field to her, and they basically reclaim the area for themselves. So that's really cool. And then she starts going inside the enemy buildings and barracks and stuff, and just owning everyone, like just defeating guys left and right, doing all sorts of like cool moves and combos. It looked amazing. And yeah, I was impressed with the fight choreography they used in this movie, and it wasn't any of that janky, shaky cam that they use in a lot of action films where you can't tell what's actually happening. Patty Jenkins, the way she directed this was to capture the action from all viewing angles, so you'd see every punch and every piece of action as it happened. So that was really nice. Let's see, what else do I want to hit on? There was a lot of jokes in this movie that were funny. One scene in particular when Wonder Woman is walking in London, you know, with Steve Trevor, she basically is wearing like a coat, and underneath she has her Wonder Woman armor suit. And since she has never been outside of her island, she's not used to how people dress and stuff like that. So she basically wants to walk around with her armor suit in World War One era London, where of course women had to wear like their traditional style of dress. They had like specific dress codes and dresses you had to wear, which she was annoyed because she couldn't fight in them. So in one scene, she basically like takes off her coat, and there's this like lady that's dressing her, and she's like, "Whoa, what's this? What is this?" And she like freaks out. So that was pretty funny. And Wonder Woman was like, "Hey, it's my armor, and here's my sword and my shield." And this lady's like, "Why do you need that stuff to walk around with?" So it was pretty funny. It's kind of like a fish out of water story at first, like an origin story, kind of what they do with lots of movies. Like it's a concept that's been used before, but it's still enjoyable nonetheless. I can't keep gushing about the action scenes though. From the beginning of the movie, there was awesome action scenes, like when Steve Trevor first lands on Wonder Woman's island. He basically encounters Diana, and behind him are all these like German soldiers following him. So they get on the island, and there's this huge fight on the beach, and all the Amazons come down and start helping and fighting, and they're pulling all sorts of like awesome moves off. Like there's this one scene where this lady like jumps off a horse, and she shoots these bows and arrows, and she manages to hit this guy and another guy and another guy with three arrows simultaneously, like shot for shot for shot, like immediately one after the other. It was really awesome, and it actually looked realistic. Like, I don't know what they used for special effects for that scene, but it did not look like CG. That was a really cool scene. There was a lot of like really nice action scenes earlier on and later in the movie. There's this one scene where a bunch of like thieves try to rob Diana and Steve Trevor as they're walking by this alley. They're like counter spies that were trying to get information from him, but they didn't know that this lady was Wonder Woman, of course. So She immediately noticed that they were being followed, and they get into this alley, and she basically takes out everyone. So that was a really cool scene. And yeah, I don't know, this movie was great, and I really enjoyed it. So that's my general take on it as a, ramble review. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you found it relaxing, please be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thanks for listening to this ramble, and yeah, I will probably do another one the next time I watch a movie at the theater. So, thanks for watching, and I will see you all next time. So long.